This show is sponsored in part by Beller Camera and Video. Visit their website and experience the Beller Camera difference.
Hey guys, Sean here, back at you with another tutorial, except this one's a little different. I've been getting a lot of questions on how to do photo shoots, fashion shoots, but today I'm gonna show you guys what I go through and what I do to set up a photo shoot. I got a makeup artist, Andrea. She is awesome. So she's from Makeup by Andy. We've got Someday to Runway. They are awesome stylists. They're breaking into the scene and they're doing a great job. So I'm honored to be working with both of them today. Also, we're shooting here in LA at Gus Harper Studios. He is an amazing artist and he's given me the honor of working today in his studio and using his paintings as backdrops. All right guys, so check out the footage we got for you guys and we're gonna go talk to everybody else and see what they're doing. Middle of the shoot right now. We've probably been shooting for a good hour or so. We're having a great time with the models, with a model, and our stylist and makeup artist are doing a bang up job. But let me go ahead and show you my lighting setup, because I know that's a big question with some of you, is how do I set up my lighting? What diffuser should I use? What should be the strength on it? Well, that really depends on the scene that you're shooting and what you're going for. Today we have a white theme going on. So everything that's here, the couch that we're using is white. The model is wearing white. So it's a mixture between bronze and white. So I love the way those two colors go together. So what I've got set up here, let me show you real quick. I have the 45 inch umbrella here with the 580 and the Pocket Wizard. I have this one set on ETTL. However, I am controlling it by this AC3. Otherwise, I would probably have this one set around 1/8 of power. Just depends. Same thing is going to go for the other umbrella that I have. If you look back over here, I've got a rim light. So I just have one 580 EX, and I have that one set at 1/64. So it'll just give a nice little rim light separating her from the background. But I do have these pretty bright, as you can see in the images that I've been showing you. I really want to be able to open up the pictures. I don't want them to be dark. These are meant to be very light and bright, and be able to bring out the detail within the makeup, the hair, and also the clothing and all the accessories. So there's some pointers for you. So make sure if you're doing a white background or a white setup that you keep your lights nice and bright. But make sure you keep an eye on your histogram, that way you don't blow out your highlights as well.
To get that HD look on camera, you always want to use like an HD product. Like Makeup Forever or whatever's online or on the stores, the beauty supply stores. But don't ever heavy up the makeup, because everything's on camera. And always very nice flow to your skin. Mineral powder is really good as well. Bronzer to the skin, nothing too heavy, because it looks very different on camera and on film.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching. I'm Demetria from Someday to Runway.
And I'm Tiffany from Someday to Runway.
And we just wanted to kind of explain to you guys how we came up with the entire look. What we came up with from the inspiration from the pictures and the makeup that we saw. We wanted to keep it all white and keep it kind of pure. There's a little bronzy in the makeup and everything, so we gave her some gold and her hair as well. Her earrings are gold, and the colors that we chose, they're kind of like a reflection from the picture. So.
And then with the sheet, we wanted to stick with cotton because of the silk and stuff wouldn't reflect it well with the camera and everything. So we just stuck with the cotton and just draped that. And then you'll see in a couple other pictures that we also used lace. So we just had the lace drawn upon her and everything. So kind of give it a different feel. Also pulling off from the picture, so you'll get the inspiration from that.
It's really innocent, really glamorous, but at the same time, it's, simple.
All right, let me go ahead and show you my lighting setup for the two scenes that we shot. First one was the all white scene, which I had two 45 inch umbrellas with the light reflected instead of a shoot through. I do like that look, as it gives me somewhat of a beauty dish look. And also I used that the 580 EX at the top left there as a rim light. I didn't want that overpowering. I just wanted a nice light separating her from the background, because as you can see that all her clothing and the environment is very white, so I wanted to be careful not to blow out my lights too much. So this is the end result of that setup. Very nice lighting, not too harsh.
Second setup was just a one light setup with a softbox. I had the 580 EX on it and I had it tilted down at a 60 degree angle. It wasn't too complicated, so it did provide a very darker feel to it as compared to the last image, which is what I wanted to go for. So as you can see, I have it pointed right overhead to complement the makeup. I did do a lot more close-up shots on this as I wanted to make sure that we brought out the detail in the makeup. So get creative. It doesn't always mean that you need a whole bunch of softboxes or lights. One can always do the trick, as you see in this photo. Hey everybody, we've come to the end of the day. We've been shooting for, 10 hours now. So it has been a long day. For those of you who do not realize how much work goes into a photo shoot, it's just as bad as filming. Really, it's a lot of work. Wouldn't you guys agree?
Yeah, good time though.
Yes.
Like we did a movie.
Yeah, they'll agree with anything I say right now. Am I just about the handsomest guy you've ever seen? My wife thinks I'm handsome.
That's what she tells me.
Love is blind. Anyways, we've had a great day. I hope you guys learned a lot, picked up some tips from makeup and from the stylist here. We've had an amazing time shooting with our model. She's exhausted. She's gonna go home and sleep like a baby. I hope you guys enjoyed the images. And if you have any more questions, please leave them in the comment section below. We will be producing a lot more of these videos for you guys to learn how to do your own photo shoots, because I know how difficult it can be. And there's not a whole lot of videos out on YouTube on how to actually set up a photo shoot, let alone a fashion shoot. So I hope this helped you guys. I hope this helped you guys out a lot. All right, guys. Much love to everybody. Thanks for watching. And make sure you watch out for these guys and click on their links and go like their page. All right, guys, take care. Bye.